Hello viewer, welcome to Samuel Academy. In this video, I want to bring you a number of common idiomatic expressions, idioms, and what they mean. The first one is a bitter pill to swallow. A bitter pill to swallow means a difficult fact to accept. Number two, a storm in a teacup. A storm in a teacup means a lot of fuss about something that is not important. Number three, we have above board. When things are done above board, it means they are done with honesty. Number four, against all odds. Against all odds means despite the difficulties. Then we have agree to disagree. When people agree to disagree, it means to stop arguing because there is no chance of agreement. Then we have all along. All along means from the beginning until now. Then we have an old wives' tale. An old wives' tale is a false belief. Then we have as a last resort. As a last resort means when all else has failed. Alright? Then we have this expression at large. When somebody is at large, it means he is free, he is not caught. Let's say when he has done some crime and he has not been caught, we say he is at large. That means he is free, he hasn't been caught. Let's go to the next slide. We have that expression, to be green. To be green means to be inexperienced. Somebody who is green is somebody without experience. To be in the know means to be well informed. Okay? To be second to none. To be second to none means to be the best. To be sound asleep means to sleep deeply. To be the apple of somebody's eye means to be very precious to somebody. To be thrown off balance means to be surprised. To have a close shave means to barely avoid an accident or a bad situation. To bear fruit means to be successful. To beat about or around the bush means to avoid saying what one means directly. Alright, then we have the following idioms. To be as busy as a bee, it means to be very busy. To be born yesterday means to be easily deceived, to be naive. Okay? When somebody says you are born yesterday, they mean that you are easily deceived or you are naive. Then you have to call it quits. To call it quits means to give up or to stop. Then we have to call somebody names. It means to insult somebody. To insult somebody. Okay? To chair a meeting is to preside over a meeting. To clear the air means to remove suspicion or bad feeling. To come clean. When people say come clean, they mean you admit the truth. So to come clean is to admit the truth. Okay? To come to a standstill means not to make progress. Okay? Like some, they can say, people can say, the whole town came to a standstill. That means nothing was going on. No progress. To come to terms with means to accept a difficult situation. The next idiomatic expression is the following. Crocodile tears. When somebody sheds crocodile tears, it means those are false tears. They are pretending. Okay? To cry over spilt milk means to grieve over something that cannot be put right. To deal a blow to means to damage one's hopes. Right? Donkey work means boring, monotonous work. Then we have down the drain. When people say that everything has gone down the drain, they mean all things have been wasted, lost. So down the drain means wasted or lost. To face the music means to be criticized or punished for something you have done. When people say fair and square, they mean within the rules, right? To fall into place. To fall into place means to become clear. Okay? When people are given a frosty welcome, it means unfriendly welcome. Let's continue to the following idiomatic expressions. To get on one's nerves means to irritate somebody. Give and take means compromise, to compromise. To give the green light to something means to give permission to proceed with something. Right? When people say, it goes without saying, go without saying, it means a foregone conclusion. Then you have this expression, a golden opportunity. It means the best chance to gain something. So when you have a golden opportunity, it means you have the best chance to gain something. And you don't need to waste that opportunity. Now, to have at one's fingertips, it means to have easily available. Like your teacher can say, you need to have that at your fingertips. That means you should be ready at any time with what you are supposed to have, all right? Now, to have no fixed abode, it means to be homeless. And then we have to have no option. To have no option means you have no choice, right? To hit the nail on the head. To hit the nail on the head means to say exactly the right thing. Next, we have the following idiomatic expressions. One is, it's all Greek to me. When people say, it is all Greek to me, they mean something new or foreign, not easily understood. So Greek, that is the Greek language, all right? So it is all Greek to me. It means it is something new or foreign, not easily understood. When people say in a flash, it means very quickly, right? Now, in a nutshell, it means briefly or in a few words. Okay? When people say in black and white, they mean in writing. So when the people say put that in black and white, they mean it should be in writing, right? In broad daylight, it means in full view of the public. So when something is done in broad daylight, it means that it was done in full view of the public. In the act of means while performing the act. So if somebody is caught in the act of doing something, it means he was caught while performing that act. Now when things are in the balance, it means it's uncertain. It's uncertain. Okay, in the long run means after a long period of time. Now when something is in the offing, it means it is likely to happen, right? More idioms, right? More idioms. We have this idiom, in the red. When things are in the red, it means that you owe money to a bank, right? When somebody says things are in the red, it means that they owe money to the bank, to a bank. Jack of all trades is somebody who is able to do a variety of jobs. Okay? Keep one's fingers crossed. To keep one's fingers crossed means hope that something will turn out well. Like when you are having a football match and one side, they keep their fingers crossed. It means that they are hoping that something will turn out well. Right? To kill two birds with one stone means to achieve two things or more things with one action. To achieve one or more things with one action. Okay? To lend an ear means to listen to somebody in a careful and sympathetic way. To let the sleeping dog lie means you avoid mentioning a subject which could cause trouble. Right? So you let the sleeping dog lie. Now, to lose heart means to become discouraged. To make a killing means to have a sudden great success, right? And then to make a living means to earn money. Next we have these expressions, to make hay while the sun shines. Okay, it means to take advantage of favorable circumstances. Okay, and then we have not hold water. When something does not hold water, it means it doesn't seem reasonable or in accordance with the facts. It doesn't hold water. Now, null and void means invalid, not legally binding. Then we have this expression of no consequence. Of no consequence means of no value, right? Off the cuff. Off the cuff means without preparation. Off the point means is relevant. Okay. When somebody is living on a shoestring, it means that they are living on a very small budget. On a shoestring, right? Now, when people say once and for all, it means for the last time. You do something once and for all. You do it once for the last time, and that's all. Once in a blue moon means a very rare occurrence, very rarely. Next, we have the following. Out of bounds. You enter some building and on the door they write out of bounds. It means it is prohibited, forbidden. You pass to a place whereby you're not supposed to enter or access. So out of bounds means prohibited or forbidden. Part and parcel. Part and parcel means to be basic part of. To be basic part of. Okay. To part company with. To part company with means to end association. You stop associating with some people. You are parted company with them. Now to play one's cards right. To play one's cards right means to act cleverly. To pull one's socks up. You have heard people say pull up your socks. So to pull one's socks up means to make a great effort. When you have this expression, to put on a brave face. To put on a brave face means to try to hide one's disappointment. To see eye to eye with somebody, it means you agree with somebody. You are in agreement with somebody. Okay, to shed light upon means to give new or further information, right? Next, we have the following, to show one's true colors. I'll show you my true colors. To show one's true colors means to reveal one's true character, right? Next, we have to spill the beans. You have heard people threaten that I'll spill the beans. To spill the beans is to reveal a secret or a fact. To stay clear of means to avoid something or somebody. Take it easy. To take it easy means not to work too hard. Okay, to relax. Alright, take somebody for granted. To take somebody for granted means not to appreciate somebody. Then we have this expression, to take the bull by the horns. To take the bull by the horns means to deal with somebody or to deal with something boldly and directly. You confront a situation. You deal with something boldly and directly. That is, you are taking the bull by the horns. Now, the lion's share. The lion's share means the biggest part or the biggest portion. The tip of the iceberg. The tip of the iceberg. You have heard people say it was just the tip of the iceberg. It means small evident part of a much larger concealed situation. A small evident part of a much larger concealed situation. Right? Tooth and nail. Tooth and nail means fiercely. I'll fight tooth and nail. That means I'll fight fiercely. Okay, to turn a blind eye to something means to ignore. And finally, we have those idioms. Tooth and nail, we have looked at it. Turn a blind eye to something, we have seen it, it is to ignore. Ups and downs. Ups and downs means good things with the bad ones. Okay. My journey has seen ups and downs. That means I've experienced the good things and bad ones. Now, when people say up and coming, they mean it's likely to be successful. And to fly, to do something with the flying colors, for example, to pass an exam with the flying colors, it means you have passed that exam with the great success. That's the end of my presentation. You can add more idioms in the comment section. Please add more idioms which I've left out in the comment section. You can also like and subscribe to my channel, Samuel Academy, so that you can promote it and for youth empowerment. Thank you so much.